Today, I'm going to be telling you why I chose the Sony A7C over the Sony A7III and why I think you should too. Alright guys, if you're watching this, then you're looking to dive into the world with Sony full-frame mirrorless cameras. Now we all know that the A7 III is an amazing camera. It's gotten tons of praise over the years since it's been released, but now we have the Sony A7C. Now, a lot of reviewers have said that the Sony A7C is just a repackaged A7 III. I'm going to tell you why I don't agree with that and why there are actually many relevant new features and improvements on this camera that make it a better buy than the A7 III. All right, let's get started. Now, one of the biggest advantages of the A7C over the A7 III is the new updated autofocus system. On the A7C, you now get eye and face detect and real-time object tracking in both photo and video modes, even in 4K. Also, according to the Sony website, you'll be able to autofocus with the A7C at one whole stop lower underexposed than the A7 III. Now don't get me wrong, the A7 III has a really good autofocus system, but the A7C is in a whole nother class. I'd say that the A7C, along with the other new Sony mirrorless cameras like the A7S III and the FX III, have the best autofocus capabilities available in the market today. Another huge improvement we see with the A7C is the finer control over the autofocus transition speed. Autofocus transition speed is how fast the camera will ramp when acquiring a new autofocus point. We now have 7 speeds to choose from, and in addition to giving us finer control over the speed, Sony has also updated the curve of the ramp to give it some deceleration. Adding deceleration to the curve makes the transition much more organic feeling. It's almost like there's a human there manually pulling focus. Just like with transition speed, Sony gave us more control over the autofocus subject shift sensitivity in the A7C. Subject shift sensitivity controls how sensitive the camera will be to shifting focus to another subject that enters the frame. In these examples, you can see that when I have the sensitivity set to 1, the focus pretty much stays locked on to the vintage camera. But when I change the setting to 5, the focus quickly snaps between Optimus Prime and the vintage camera and back again. Alright, let's talk about the swivel screen. I know Sony is a little late to the game here, but better late than never, right? With the 270 degrees of screen rotation, you can pretty much shoot in any orientation that you can think of and still be able to see your screen. Some of these positions would be near impossible with the A7 III. One of the coolest things that Sony's doing in their new mirrorless cameras is they're embedding gyro metadata into the video. If you don't know what a gyro sensor is, it's a sensor that measures changes in angular velocity. Pretty much, it's just measuring how your camera is moving in all 5 axes. Along with the new cameras, Sony has also released accompanying software called Catalyst Browse, which is free to use. Now what Catalyst Browse does is it uses the gyro metadata to help stabilize shaky footage in post. Now in my test, Catalyst Browse plus gyro data has worked super well for stabilizing footage, and I think it's a huge plus for the A7C over the A7 III, which has no gyro metadata. All right, here's some test footage of me running alongside my son while he's riding his bike. Now, this is no IBIS, no steady shot, no optical steady shot, no gimbal. This is all handheld, me running next to the bike, and all stabilization is done in post with Catalyst Browse. And I have to say, I am super happy with the way this turned out. I'm blown away by this technology. I think it works amazingly well. All right, here's another big one for the A7C. The A7C has no recording limit. The A7 III, on the other hand, has a recording limit of 29 minutes and 59 seconds, which could be super annoying. I mean, say you sat down for an interview or you go to shoot a pretty long YouTube video, I think it would be pretty common to run over 30 minutes. And so the fact that they finally got rid of that and there's no recording limit on this camera, I think is a huge plus. So the A7 III and other older Sony cameras have some really weird HDMI quirks. The most annoying quirk being that if you wanted to record internally while outputting 4K video via HDMI to an external monitor, you lost face detect. Now this is a huge annoyance, because what it means is that on the older Sony cameras, if you wanted to keep face detection but monitor on an external monitor, it meant that you needed to pony up and buy an external recording monitor like a Atomos Ninja 5 or something like that, which can be really pricey. Thankfully, I can confirm that Sony has fixed this issue on the A7C. Now, I can record internally, output full 4K video to an external non-recording monitor, and keep face and eye detect, which is amazing. It's something that gets overlooked a lot in other reviews, and I think it's very important, because as someone who's like filming myself a lot, I find an external monitor super helpful, and the fact that I would lose face detection was super annoying. All right, let's talk about the size of the camera. This one's a little weird for me because it actually falls into the pro and the cons for me, because in use, I actually prefer a camera that's a little larger and a little heavier. I have pretty big hands, and also added weight helps to stabilize shaky footage, you know, get rid of some of those little jitters. So in use, I actually prefer a heavier camera. But what I do like about the A7C's size is for when I'm packing up for travel. Now I know that a lot of other reviewers have said that the A7C is pretty close to the size of an A7III if you imagine the EVF chopped off and the grip shrunk. Now, I don't think it's really fair to say that, right? Because when you think about how a camera fits into a camera bag, it doesn't just conform to the shape of the camera, right? It's the largest dimensions of the camera that really matter. It's the volume of the camera that matters. So I think that's the metric that we have to look at. So if we look at the volume of the A7C versus the A7III, we have 526 cubic centimeters for the A7C and about 894 cubic centimeters for the A7III. That's about a 41% decrease in volume for the A7C. Now, if we talk about weight, the A7C comes in at 509 grams, while the A7III comes in at 650 grams. So that's a 22% decrease in weight for the A7C. Now, if you put those two metrics together, that's a pretty big difference when trying to pack something into a bag. And a lot of times when I'm just out running and gunning, I'll be using like a sling or some kind of smaller bag. So that smaller size and weight makes a difference. Do I really need to talk about the doors? I think everybody knows that the A7III has horrible dangly doors. They feel cheap. They can chatter, which can be picked up by your microphone. It's just not a nice experience. Thankfully, Sony has updated the door design on the A7C, and now it feels much more quality and robust. And I do like the attention to detail. They thought about the door design. You can tell because the bottom door actually flips downward, and what that does is that it keeps it from blocking the swivel screen when it's in selfie mode. All right, let's talk a little bit about battery efficiency. Now, according to Sony's website, the A7C is a little more efficient than the A7III. They say for still images, you'll get 70 more shots on the A7C using the EVF and 30 more shots using the monitor. So this suggests that the smaller EVF has a role in the increased battery life, but it's not the entire story. Looking at the numbers on the Sony website, it looks like you can expect around an 11% increase in battery life on average with the A7C over the A7III. So, not huge, but it's something. All right, I've gone over the major differences between the two cameras. Now, after using the A7C for a while, I've found a lot of other small improvements over the A7III. Now, they may not be huge flashy things like a Flippy screen, but I think all these little things add up. Now, I'm not gonna go over every improvement that I've found, but I'm gonna go over the ones that I think are either gonna help people take better photos, get better video, or just help with workflow. First, let's talk about the mode dial. The A7C's mode dial is borrowed from the new A7S3's mode dial, where now you have the video and the manual shooting modes right next to each other. And also, now we have three slots on the memory recall, so you have just one more setting that you can store there, which is super nice. So the A7C also has a better illuminated focus box than the A7III. The A7III had this gray focus box, and on a lot of backgrounds it was really hard to see and you couldn't tell where it was a lot of the time. Now on the A7C it's a lot brighter, and you can also choose between it, the color being white or red, which is super nice. One annoyance that I had with the A7III was that when I was setting up the custom buttons, they didn't show pictures of the camera. I had to just read the words, which, yeah, it's fine and you can get it to work, but it's not a nice user experience. Where the A7C, now there's a picture of the camera and with all the buttons highlighted of what you're working on. So it's a huge improvement, and I'm not sure why Sony didn't do that to begin with, but now it's like so much nicer. Another thing that I love about the A7C is that now we have different function menus for taking stills or video. Before, you had one function menu, so you had to pick and choose what functions you put in there very wisely because you had to use it both for photos and video, but now you can have separate function menus for both, and it just makes it a lot cleaner that way. Now the last thing I want to talk about is something that maybe a lot of people don't care about, but I really care about, and I think it's the aesthetics of the camera. I think that the A7C is probably the prettiest camera that Sony's made, maybe ever. I mean, this thing looks super sharp. I got the silver version, and it just takes me back to those old vintage camera vibes, and I love it. All right, so I've talked about all the things that I like about the A7C. But now let's talk about some of the things that I don't like about the A7C. So the first being the EVF. Now I don't have as much of a problem with it as some people do. I think it's totally fine and usable. It's about 22% smaller than the A7III's EVF. And I think the resolution is fine. The colors are great. The thing that I don't like is that they didn't put an eye cup. I mean, even on the A6400, A6600, we had the removable eye cup. Now, I think that would have been a really good compromise between keeping the size small and giving us good shade for our eye. I'm not sure why they didn't include that. Must have been a cost-saving thing or what, but that's one annoyance I have. I just wish it had an eye cup. Now, I'm not a full-time professional photographer or videographer, so this one is not as important to me, but I know it is for some of you guys out there. So the A7C does not have dual card slots, so you can't make redundant copies of your images or videos on camera. So if that's really important for you, then that might be a big con with the A7C. Now the next topic, I debated whether I even wanted to put this on there or not, but a lot of people have brought it up, and it's the fact that the A7C has less customizable buttons than the A7III or other, you know, full-size body Sony mirrorless cameras. Now for me, it hasn't been an issue at all, actually. You can customize the movie record button, you can customize the AF on button, you can customize the C button, and all of the buttons on the directional pad, you can change to something else if you want, and you can customize the enter button as well. As much as I would like to have a dedicated ISO dial, it's actually not that bad having it on the wheel, because by default, the wheel changes shutter speed, right? But just with one click to the right, I can keep my thumb on the same location and have this two controls under one finger, which actually, once you get the muscle memory for that, it actually works out really nice. And so that, in addition to the additional memory recall on the mode dial, it's like I haven't had any complaints there. Like, I can shoot and change modes super fast. I think it's just all about muscle memory. And if you got this camera, I have no doubt that you could get used to it and it could work in your workflow seamlessly. Now the form factor of the camera is a pro, but it's also a con for me because I do have larger hands and I do wish the grip was bigger and I wish the camera was a little bigger and I wish it did have a little extra weight because it really helps to get rid of some of those tiny micro jitters when you're shooting video. Like I said before, the size and the weight is a pro and a con for me. The next complaint I have is that Sony for some reason removed the multi-port on this camera. Now I'm not sure why they did that. I guess maybe it was a cost-saving thing, I don't know. They removed the multi-port on this camera, so now I can't use any of my old remotes. I have to go buy a Bluetooth remote for this camera. It's not too bad, I guess, but it kind of annoys me. One issue that I've run into with this camera is that on a super bright day, like if you're shooting high noon, I wish the shutter speed went faster, like to 1 over 8,000. This camera, the A7C, only goes up to 1 over 4,000. So I've actually found myself, if I have the aperture pretty wide open, even with an ND filter, I couldn't, with a 2-5 stop ND filter, I could not get the shot I wanted because I was overexposed. So it would have been nice to be able to up that shutter speed to 1 over 8,000. The last thing that I don't like about the A7C is the grip material. Now, I think that Sony definitely made a form over function call here with the grip material. It looks beautiful, but it's just not tacky enough. Like on the A7 III or even the A6400, A6600, those grips, they don't look as beautiful, but they feel great. They feel like you're holding on to something really grippy and tacky and you're not gonna drop it. The A7C, I'm just kind of like sketched out when I'm holding it. So we'll see, maybe I'll get used to it. Maybe it'll get broken in and it'll get tacky over time. I don't know, but we'll see about that. At the end of the day, you really can't go wrong with either the A7 III or the A7C. But in my opinion, the A7C is a better camera. And if you're looking to get into the Sony full frame camera world, then I think this is where you want to be looking. All right, guys, that's all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you guys have any questions, comments, suggestions, drop them down below. I promise I'll read them and get back to you as soon as I can. My name is Matt. Until next time, I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching.